name is Sarah Carino-Coza, and I am Director of Bands at Spotswood High School. I'm so honored to welcome you to Virtually Swinging, the 2021 Jazz and Such Concert. Tonight's program will feature an outstanding variety of selections spanning multiple genres, and of course, spotlights the extraordinary talent of our musicians at Spotswood High School. We hope that you and your family are settled in for a great night of swing, funk, a little classical, and a whole lot of fun. Our program begins with a piano solo played by freshman pianist Cyan Chan. Her selection, La Plus Que Lent, by Claude Debussy, which roughly translates to More Than Slow, is actually more related to jazz than you might think. Composed in 1910, this waltz for solo piano was one of the many French impressionist pieces that slowly began to influence who would be some of the great jazz artists of our time. Jazz was a new style in the early 1900s, and the French were completely enamored with its harmonies, rhythms, syncopations. You could say that French impressionism and jazz had a somewhat contemporaneous relationship. They began to be a bit reflective of one another. Cyan's interpretation will give you a wonderful view into the beauty of this compositional style, with her mature phrasing, elegant touch, and attention to every nuance on the page. This is Cyan Chan performing Claude Debussy's La Plus Que Lent. Thank you. Our next selection is one of the most recognizable jazz tunes of all time. Written by the great alto saxophonist Paul Desmond, an original member of the Dave Brubeck Quartet, Take Five became an iconic hit played by that very same Dave Brubeck Quartet. This chart debuted on their 1959 album entitled Time Out, which featured the usage of time signatures that were at the time rather uncommon for jazz music. Take Five, of course, aptly named, is written in 5/4, which you'll feel as 3 beats plus 2 beats. So you'll find that you're tapping your foot in groups of five, and perhaps the first beat is a little stronger, and then the fourth beat is a little stronger. So we kind of divide that into a 3 plus 2. The album Time Out is an absolute must for anyone looking to learn more and get into jazz music. It was the first album ever to sell 1 million copies, and in 2009, it was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame. Our performance tonight is actually one of the truly live in-person and few in-person performances that we've been able to do this year. It features me on the piano, Samara Schreck on drums, and Joe Perkins on the alto sax, who will treat you to the original Paul Desmond solo. He'll play that right in the middle. So sit back and enjoy Take Five, performed tonight by the Joe Perkins Trio. As we move to the jazz band portion of tonight's performance, I wanted to give you all at home some insights into what has made this virtual concert possible. After auditions in early January, this dedicated group spent early evenings on Monday and Wednesdays in an experimental and constantly evolving rehearsal format on Zoom. We spent quite a bit of time listening to each other play individually, something that we actually didn't do all that frequently in our regular rehearsals. And the band really had to rely heavily on their critical listening skills to essentially teach themselves the music using the professional recordings, along with some guidance from me. We used the share sound feature in Zoom to play together with the recording, though of course everyone was on mute. And then we did a decent amount of individual practice time in breakout rooms and then of course outside of Zoom. If you're not familiar with how a jazz band works, it's really hard for me to overstate how difficult it is to feel the vibe of a piece without having other musicians around you to give body language cues or other inflections. It's like trying to hear someone's voice a few rooms over, but you can't see them and you can't try to make out what they're saying. I say all of this because if you close your eyes for a moment, you'll swear that we are all in the same space, hearing and feeling music the same exact way. And there is a little bit of magic in having developed our group dynamic over the last few years to the point where even when we're apart, we're hearing and understanding music the exact same way. Our first selection tonight, Cottontail, was written by the great Duke Ellington in 1940 and is actually based on the rhythm changes in George Gershwin's tune, I Got Rhythm. An interesting historical note here is that in the early years that jazz was popular, most compositions were written with the sole intention of being something that you could dance to. Cottontail was incredibly unique in that it was written to be listened to. It was actually rather difficult to kind of get a leg up on the beat due to the fact that the melody starts on the upbeat of one. So it doesn't start on the strong beat of the measure, which makes it difficult to sort of get into the rhythm and feel, you know, kind of the speed and the cadence of the piece. And so some say that Cottontail was kind of the first of its kind, proving that jazz music could be enjoyed for its own sake without the dance element. I'll be filling in on an alto sax and piano solo, but you won't want to miss Sean Ignotis and his solo debut on trumpet. And we certainly save the best for last with newcomer Preston Smith on drums for an absolutely scorching riff to close out this number. So sit back and enjoy Duke Ellington's Cottontail.
Thank you.
band, being the kind of ensemble that it is, really frees us up to do some fun, out-of-the-box collaborations and combos. Whenever we have vocal talent in our band program, I try to use as much of it as I can. Because when you're in a band, you get really good at playing with other instruments, but playing with a vocalist is a rather different experience. There are different considerations for what dynamics mean, for example, what melody in your part means, and also how we have to be a bit more flexible with time to allow for the unique nature of the human voice. In the same vein, young vocalists don't often get to sing with a live band outside of a theater experience. As a director, I rely on the vocalists to bring their own interpretation to the repertoire, and we work together to find a good balance of what works for the vocals and what works for the band. So really, it's a wonderfully rich learning opportunity that gives all of us something just a little different. Many of you at home are likely no stranger to the vocal stylings of songstress Adele, and I'm sure many were equally struck by the sheer beauty of this next song. The vocals, written by Adele with a great instrumental accompaniment arranged by Roger Holmes, this came from the 2013 James Bond film Skyfall. The band absolutely fell in love with this while rehearsing it, and I think you'll agree that Haley Sosnowski's interpretation is one that speaks of vocal maturity, incredible musicianship, and deep, deep soul. For sure, this has been the collaboration that we've been most excited about, and we are so honored to share it with you tonight. Here is Skyfall.
We will stand tall, face it all together. you see, I see. I know I will never be me without the security of your loving arms, keeping me from harm. Put your hand in my hand and we'll stand. Let the sky fall, when it crumbles, we will stand tall. Face it all together. Let the sky fall.
Before we end with our final selection, I would be remiss if I didn't acknowledge our seniors, most of whom have spent 4 years in this group, learning, growing, and leaving behind a legacy that we will continue in their absence. Alexis Faust on bass, Madison Faust on tenor sax, Jada Fenner on trombone, Ben Leiby on tenor sax, Shannon Longmore on trumpet, Joe Perkins on barry sax, and Skylar Prevell on trumpet. Thank you all so, so much for all of your hard work and dedication throughout these 4 years, particularly this past year. And we love you and we'll miss you. And of course, there will always be a chair for you in this ensemble whenever you're home and you want to jam with us again. I also want to thank the Board of Education, Superintendent Grant Peabody, Selena Pewitt, Amy Jablonski, Mike Mastroserio, Gina DiVincenzo, and the entire SHS faculty for their constant support and enthusiasm for our program. Also, a special thanks to our student teacher this semester, Mr. Mauricio Molina, for sharing his skills and talents with us. Another huge thanks to the SBPA, which always continues to support and cheerlead for us. And a final thanks to my husband, Brian, who somewhat willingly let me spend some time away from our spring break vacation to edit and put this virtual concert together. The final chart tonight is a special one for us. This was a song that we rehearsed in 2020, and it would have been on our concert program in March of last year. It also would have been one of the charts that we would have played in competition on the band trip in Washington, D.C. And it was actually the last song that we played together before the lockdown began. It was easily the band's favorite, and I knew for all of those reasons I would need to bring it back for this year, whatever our setup would be. We're super thrilled to be able to finally perform this for you tonight, especially because it's both a little reminder of what it felt like to perform together and also a little beacon of hope that those times are just around the corner. You'll hear some expert solos played by Jada Fenner on trombone, Joe Perkins on barry sax, and Charlie Johnson on guitar. So here we go with Gordon Goodwin's very funky Crunchy Frog. Thank you. Going to do it for us here at Virtually Swinging, the 2021 SHS Jazz and Such concert. We hope you enjoyed the music tonight, and we can't wait to play for you again in person sometime very soon. Good night.